Good afternoon, everybody. I'm Dill Hero, sitting here with my partner, Lightning Slim, and you are watching the 2015 International WFTDA Division II Playoffs live from Cleveland, Ohio, brought to you by the Women's Flat Track Roller Derby Association and Burning River Roller Derby.
So what we're about to see is the St. Chuck's Derby Chicks Pack in Black taking on the Brandywine Belligerents. St. Chuck's is from O'Fallon, Missouri. Right now they're ranked 54th in the Women's Flat Track Derby Association. Brandywine, hailing from Downingtown, Pennsylvania, ranked 62nd. So this will be a Division II matchup.
Division II matchup, indeed, rematchup, and we'll get to that later. Let's get to these rosters right now. St. Chuck's Derby Chicks roster goes as 103 Calamity Cat, number 12 Judy Boom, number 14 Psycho Kitty Freakout, number 18 Sugar Shock, number 187 Zombie F-Bomb, number 22 Terror Eyes, number 4 Jedi Nightingale, number 417 Shakilia, number 47 Whiplash, number 480 Pixie Destruction, number 5 Slaughterhouse, number 50 50 Shades of Pink, number 501 Darth Molly, number 80 Connor, number 831 Joni Ramone, number 888 Big Red, and the captain on the bench, or the coach on the bench, Night Glider.
And the Brandywine Roller Girls, Brandywine Belligerents, they will be wearing white in this contest. Skater number 101, Rapid Arrhythmia, the captain. Number 121, Crash Bandicoot. 138, Buenos Dias. Number 1979, Lurs Lemon. 23, Thresher. 2320, Velociraptor. 247, Anya All Night. Number 273, Not Naughty. Number 67, Slam Shine Alley. 728, Ballerenka. 757, Cutthroat Casey. 777, Cash and Prizes. Number 789, Decker Hater. Number 79, Raggedy Aneurysm. And number 9, Skinny Guinea. On the bench for Brandywine, Hot Wheels.
Yeah, here we go. St. Chuck's Derby Chicks. Misspoke a little bit earlier. Calamity Cat and Judy Boom not on this roster, going out on the track for this rematch, the rematch of Friday's game. We saw the earlier rematch just seconds ago, Jet City in Oklahoma, and a flippity-floppity, if you will, of wins.
That is a fine term, flippity and floppity.
Make it official. Hashtag that. All right, on the fast girls start line right now. For the Belligerents, we have Buenos Dias and Jedi Nightingale for St. Chuck's.
In the previous meeting of these two teams on Friday, St. Chuck's able to take the win over Brandywine by just 10 points, 206 to 196.
And here we go, Buenos Dias at the front of that pack, immediately trying to get her way out, and she does, a little stumbly, and she is the lead jammer, drawing first blood. The Belligerents controlling the jam at this time. Meanwhile, we're going to see Jedi Nightingale getting out of the pack. Her initial out of the pack pass now up for score, and Buenos Dias calling off the jam.
First blood to Brandywine, 3-0 with just 29 minutes remaining in the first period of play. Jedi Nightingale held scoreless on that jam, but previously a force to be reckoned with, Dill.
That's right. She definitely is. Jedi Nightingale, super strong force. This, again, is a rematch of a game we saw on Friday, St. Chuck's Derby Chicks versus Brandywine Roller Girls. In that first contest, St. Chuck's took it, and we're going to see what's going to happen here right now. Lurs Lemon on the start girls skate line, and Psycho Kitty Freakout for St. Chuck's. And Lurs Lemon out of that pack fast and quick as the lead jammer representing Brandywine. Meanwhile, Psycho Kitty Freakout having a little bit of a difficult time. Recycled to the back of the pack, and that gives Lurs Lemon a little bit of an opening as they are concentrating on her for 5 points for Brandywine.
And Lurs Lemon with a spin maneuver to come out of the pack once again. Lurs Lemon has been doing some heavy lifting for Brandywine in their previous bout against Oklahoma Victory Doll. She put up 91 points in that bout, and there's five more for her.
Wow, well, she's doing it again right now. Another 5 points, 10 points total right now. Brandywine sitting at 13, and she is into the pack once again. Recycled to the back by the pivot, Tara Eyes from St. Chuck's. And now we're seeing St. Chuck's three wall holding her firmly just inside of turn three. Meanwhile, just outside of turn three, we're seeing Psycho Kitty Freakout being held just as firmly by the blocking maneuvers.
Yeah, the Brandywine defender stretching out that pack, bridging as far as they possibly can before a Psycho Kitty Freakout is able to escape. She does so.
She does so after some force. Not an easy situation. She gets out of the pack, but just got the jam called off. 17-0 right now, 27 minutes left in the first half of the rematch.
Lewis Lemon had a little bit more time to play with, but she knew Psycho Kitty Freakout had exited the pack, so she decided to call it off immediately. I think that was a smart play.
Right now on the Fast Girls start line, we have Connor for St. Chuck's and Raggedy Aneurysm for Brandywine. And Connor immediately working around the front, and she is lead jammer, now controlling the jam. Meanwhile, Raggedy Aneurysm, a lot of trouble in the back of the pack caused by number 47, Whiplash.
Raggedy Aneurysm able to dodge around some defenders.
Well, Connor controlling that jam. She gets out for 5 points. First 5 points for St. Chuck's, but hot on her tail, Raggedy Aneurysm.
That jam was a bit of a mad scramble, and I think St. Chuck's took advantage of some of the chaos to grab that position on the scoreboard, Dill.
Yeah, a lot of chaos out there right now on the Skate Girl start line. We're looking at number 67, Slam Shine Alley for Brandywine, and Jedi Nightingale for St. Chuck's.
Jedi Nightingale, 117 points versus Brandywine on Friday in 15 jams of play.
Well, St. Chuck's moving immediately to the front of that pack. A Jedi Nightingale trying to push her way through. But Slam Shine Alley find a little bit on the inside, and she is out as your lead jammer.
A blocker from each team making their way to the derbysupply.net penalty box. And two more. One from each team.
Wow, here she goes, calling off the jam.
A couple more penalized players, drawing our attention to derbysupply.net. For all your derby needs, derbysupply.net. Just hit it.
Just hit it. Now on the Fast Girl start line, we're seeing Buenos Dias returning for Brandywine. And Psycho Kitty Freakout for St. Chuck's. We're two players down on each pack, so we're looking at just four players out there for each pack.
Some of these jammers like that room to skate, Dill.
A lot of room to skate there right now, and that's right now in Buenos Dias' favor. Psycho Kitty Freakout. Apologies. Psycho Kitty Freakout is the lead jammer for St. Chuck's.
She's already made her way around back inside the pack.
Looked like an out-of-play call for number 23.
Buenos Dias had pulled off her helmet cover. She stashed the star to stealth her way out of the pack. But the jam over.
The jam over right now. 10-21, 24 minutes and change left in the first half of the rematch.
A fairly clean affair thus far. Just a couple of penalties to each squad. Nobody with more than a single.
All right, we're looking at Sugar Shock right now on the Fast Girls start line. Up against Lurs Lemon. Lurs Lemon, a strong, strong jammer for Brandywine, and she gets out of that pack as the lead jammer. And removing the star, trying to put it back on. Not working out as Lurs Lemon calls it off right away. Four more points for Brandywine.
Yeah, Sugar Shock looked like she was having a bit of trouble fiddling with the helmet cover, which cost, you know, just that precious half second as she thought about it.
All right, and for Brandywine, Raggedy Aneurysm returning to the start line, and Jedi Nightingale for St. Chuck's.
Jedi Nightingale with a nice button hook maneuver to get her into lead jammer position.
Yeah, quick around the pack, quick around the track and back to the pack. There she goes, a little spin out right there, recycle to the back. We're still waiting on Raggedy Aneurysm trying to break through that St. Chuck's defense. And there she goes, Jedi Nightingale through the inside with a 5 in the sky, 5 more points for St. Chuck's.
Although that was actually some tidy defensive work early on. An apex jump by Jedi Nightingale goes awry, and she gets the track cutting penalty, heads to the DerbySupply.net penalty box.
Well, that's going to leave Raggedy Aneurysm as the only jammer on the track as the pack patiently awaits just inside of turn 4. And there they go, taking off a 4-wall right there from St. Chuck's, trying to shut it down and hold her at bay in turn 1. She makes quick work of it on the inside. 5 points right there for Brandywine.
A couple of the defenders from St. Chuck's looking a bit winded. And they need this penalty kill right now if they want to stop the progress of Raggedy Aneurysm, although they have killed the penalty as far as they could, and Jedi Nightingale is back.
Well, Jedi Nightingale back in play.
And a star pass from Brandywine. Raggedy Aneurysm passing off the star to number 9. Now the jammer for Brandywine.
Number 9, Skinny Guinea. And she's making good use of that star pass. 4 points right there for Brandywine.
Skinny Guinea found a skinny space around the outside line.
And there she goes again. Right up the middle with another 4 points for Brandywine. Brandywine walking away slowly right now, 23-38, and the jam continues. There she goes again, right at the last moment, diving into that pack. 4 more points for Brandywine. That's going to put them 27-42. We have an official timeout right now at 20 minutes and some change left in this first half of the rematch from Friday.
And that was such a subtle little head fake that Skinny Guinea did as she passed through the center of the pack. She just sort of nodded her head in the one direction while the rest of her went the other.
Super fake out.
Yeah, it was very effective in helping her split the defenders there.
Well, this is now an official review.
We'd like to take an opportunity. The WFTDA would like to thank our friends at Something Inked. Thank you, Something Inked. So we can take a moment to talk about how we got here, Dill. As we said, there was that matchup on Friday, St. Chuck's defeating Brandywine 206-196. And on Saturday, St. Chuck's lost to the Kansas City Roller Warriors. And then later on Saturday, had a win over Jet City.
Yeah, Brandywine on the other side of that, like we talked about, lost to St. Chuck's. Won against Treasure Valley on Saturday, and then played again on Saturday with a win against Oklahoma. We're looking at the penalties right now. There's not a lot to talk about.
Cut track on the jammer of Brandywine, cutting the non-initiator. Initiator went to the box, but non-initiators to be cut.
So the review concerning track cutting penalty, some question as to whether the cut was made on the initiator or non-initiator of contact. We will have more details as they come.
That's right. We're sitting 27-42, 20 minutes, 48 seconds left in the first half. You're listening to and watching 2015 International WFTDA Division II from Cleveland, Ohio.
And if you want to see some of those wonderful stats that we are looking at, you can join us on stats-repo, repo.wftda.com. That's where the stats repository is, and you can share in the wonderful knowledge.
More stats than you can ever imagine in there.
It really is a rabbit hole, folks. You can fall down in there and find out everything you ever wanted to know. We'd also like to thank our friends at Sin City Skates. SinCityskates.com, the first, the best, happy to fix the rest.
Now still, we're still got some time going on discussing this track cut official review.
Head referee Tootie Tinwhistle there explaining things to the coaches and captains.
And we just saw earlier, we were talking about Jet City and Oklahoma, their rematch. And Jet City had lost originally on Friday, but then came back and won it.
And we have it on good authority that this is the first time that two rematches have occurred within one of the WFTDA's tournament structures.
Well, there you go.
Pretty cool.
Yeah, 10 years of WFTDA magic, and we just made a little bit more history.
We have some clarification on that from Double H.
Yes, 2D10 Whistle said no cuts occurred by said Brandywine jammer.
Thank you very much, Double H. So definitive, no cuts. 5-second warning given. We're getting back into the action.
And on the Fast Girls start line, Psycho Kitty Freakout returning for St. Chuck's and Slam Shine Alley for Brandywine. This jam is underway. Everything stays the way it was, and there we go. Psycho Kitty Freakout out of the pack. Lead jammer for St. Chuck's.
And she's on a power jam, Dill.
Yeah, a back block sending her to the DerbySupply.net penalty box, and that gives 5 points right there for Psycho Kitty Freakout of St. Chuck's.
Psycho Kitty not going to be satisfied with that. She immediately reapplies herself to the pack.
And this is a huge opportunity right now for them to close the gap as we were sitting at a 10-point game just a few moments ago, but she continues to stack them up. 5 more points for Psycho Kitty Freakout in St. Chuck's.
The pack standing still, although there's inter-pack hitting occurring.
Well, and as we see with these short penalties right now, Slamshine Alley back in play in the back of that pack, released from the penalty box. Meanwhile, Psycho Kitty Freakout is just having to walk her way to the outside, gets outside of the pack with 5 more points for St. Chuck's.
Slamshine Alley was just able to complete her initial pass as Psycho Kitty Freakout was able to step around on the outside line in turn number 4 to put up her 15th point of the jam.
Well, now we're sitting at a tie game, 42-42, 19 minutes left in the first half. And we're seeing Buenos Diaz returning to the line for Brandywine and Connor for St. Chuck's. And Buenos Diaz skipping on 1 foot, trying to stay inside, and she does. Up to, just called out for a forearm block.
Buenos Diaz with the forearm. She will take a seat in the DerbySupply.net penalty area.
Well, that'll leave Connor back alone as the jammer, and she's going to try to get through this pack, obviously, and try to score some more points to break this tie game. It seems like almost a repeat jam of the previous jam. And she is the lead jammer.
Buenos Diaz was joined by her pivot, not Naughty, in the penalty area. So a depleted pack there for Brandywine.
Depleted it may be, but still a nice little hit from Brandywine. But she recovers nicely as Connor gets back up, comes out for another 5 points.
And that was some nice retaliatory pack hitting from St. Chuck's. Do not touch our jammer or you will pay the consequences.
Kind of a little explosion in turn one. Well, right now, 47-42, 18 minutes left in the first half.
S1 Helmets. You can see them at s1helmets.com. S1 Helmets are rad. Get rad.
Get rad. We're on official timeout right now.
High scorers as of the moment. Psycho Kitty Freakout for St. Chuck's has 20 points across 3 jams of action. Lurs Lemon for the Belligerents has 18 points in 2 jams of work.
All right, now we're seeing Jedi Nightingale on the Fast Girls start line all alone.
What a maneuver. Jedi Nightingale with quick lateral movement gains lead.
Yeah, she was quick out of that pack. Meanwhile, we're seeing Buenos Diaz returning from the box and back in play. Jedi Nightingale immediately calling it off, but 4 more points for St. Chuck's.
Jedi Nightingale displaying some mathematical fingers to her jammer referee. She knew how many points she had scored. and wanted to make sure that the referee concurred.
Sometimes they agree. Sometimes they don't.
All 17 right. minutes remaining in the first period of play. St. Chuck's 51, Brandywine a score of 42.
All right. Lurs a lemon on the line for Brandywine. And Psycho Kitty Freakout returning for St. Chuck's. This jam is underway. Psycho Kitty Freakout.
Oh, an attempted apex jump by Lurs Lemon, although she was facing backwards. What a high-risk maneuver, and it didn't quite work as she is completely recycled.
Right, and we just saw Psycho Kitty freak out, pushed out at the same time. Both jammers recycled to the back, but Lurs Lemon with the better recovery as she pushed to the inside and got lead jammer.
Lurs Lemon, she tried some crazy stuff, although that was a nice recovery as she was able to gain lead.
And Lurs Lemon back in the pack. Nice opening right there as she works her way through, adding some more score. Five more points for Brandywine. We've got ourselves a back and forth here. We're 51 to 47. Points still coming up on the board. Lurs Lemon cutting the track, called out for cutting the track.
And just as Lurs Lemon was pulling into the lead of the scoring race in this bout, she takes that penalty and will have to sit in the DerbySupply.net penalty box.
Wow, she was on a strong pull for Brandywine to add the points onto this board. But meanwhile, Psycho Kitty Freakout now released St. Chuck's with the only jammer. And she, on her toe stop run, a little bit of a spin around, gets out of that pack with the three-wall defense.
Nice.
5 points right now for St. Chuck's.
Nice support from her pivot, Ballerinka, to help get her through the pack.
A ballerina move, thanks to Ballerinka.
That time, Ballerinka let her go, and Psycho Kitty Freakout was able to do the work herself to get through for five.
Whoa, an amazing high jump, but didn't work out. Lurs Lemon.
No apex that Lurs Lemon will not attempt to jump over. Oh.
Wow. Lurs Lemon taken out to the side by the pivot right there from St. Chuck's, and that'll end this jam with three more points for St. Chuck's.
Yeah, that was a heavy collision and a crushing blow right inside the starting box area.
Nobody stayed down. That's a good sign.
We are in an official timeout with exactly 15 minutes remaining. Oh, wait, no. Adjustment to the clock there. 14:35, St. Chuck's 64, Brandywine 47. If you're just joining us, this is the 2015 International WFTDA Division II Playoffs from beautiful Cleveland, Ohio. He is Dill Hero, and I am Lightning Slim.
That's right, and we're getting ready to start this next jam off the fast girl start line. Raggedy Aneurysm for Brandywine and Sugar Shock for St. Chuck's.
Sugar Shock, in two jams of previous appearances, has not been able to make a mark on the scoreboard thus far. Meanwhile, Raggedy Aneurysm has put up 5 points over four jams of work, mainly being used in a relief capacity. We'll see what she does here.
Right, well, both jammers respectively pushed out to either side of the pack and then recycling. And Sugar Shock back into the front of the pack with the defense holding her. Oh, finds a little bit on the inside, and she is out as the lead jammer. Sugar Shock now with an opportunity to make some points for her team as she is back into the pack. In turn one, ooh, a nice knockdown. Calls off the jam. 4 points.
Yeah, that helps St. Chuck continue to hang on to their lead, 68 to 51, with just under 14 minutes remaining.
Up on the Fast Girls skate line right now, Slam Shine Alley for Brandywine. And Jedi Nightingale returning for St. Chuck's. And Jedi Nightingale up to the front of that pack. Quick work. She is the lead jammer.
Jedi Nightingale took a quick look over her shoulder as she exited the pack. She didn't know where her opponent was. Slam Shine Alley has left the pack.
Yep, and here we go. Jedi Nightingale with 4 points for St. Chuck's. St. Chuck's racking it up, 72 to 51. She calls it off immediately. We're sitting at 72-51, 12:56 left on the official clock for the first half.
Let's talk about Fast Girl Skates. FastGirlSkates.com. Blue Streak. Get yours from the source. Fast Girl Skates.
Buenos Dias on the line for Brandywine, and Psycho Kitty Freakout returning to the line for St. Chuck's.
Psycho Kitty Freakout, the current high scorer for St. Chuck's at 33 points.
What a force she has been this weekend for her team. Recycled to the back right now. Three of the Brandywine defenders holding her at bay. Meanwhile, we're seeing a two-wall holding Buenos Dias. Had to let her go. Lead jammer.
Buenos Dias has exhibited that patience to outweigh the pack definition time and time again in this tournament.
And Psycho Kitty Freakout breaking out of the pack on her initial pass, and Buenos Dias calling it off. Four more points for Brandywine.
Buenos Dias, that will bring her to 7 points over five jams in the contest.
And Lurs Lemon on the line right now for Brandywine.
Lurs Lemon currently sitting on 100% lead jam status in the game thus far. Connor pushed to the outside.
And there she goes. Lurs Lemon out of that pack as the lead jammer.
The streak continues, Dill. 100% lead jammer.
100%. Proving it once again. Diving in. Causing a little bit of destruction. And that's a back block. That dive in is going to cost her a back block and send her to the DerbySupply.net penalty box.
Yeah, she had her eyes on the center of the pack and she wanted to get in there, but unfortunately a body drifted into the way.
Well, that'll leave Connor out there to score some points for St. Chuck's. 4 points. And quickly getting through that pack again. Now 5 points for Connor.
And that was another pretty head fake, this time on the St. Chuck's side, as Connor juked inside but then went to the outs. Oh, she does it again, and a spin.
Yeah, they're not catching on to that. She's really good at faking them out with her eyes and her head movement, as she's through one more time for 5 more points.
Lurs Lemon is back.
Lurs Lemon is back, and here we go. Two defenders recycling Connor to the back of that pack. She didn't get away with that juking and jiving this time.
The reappearance of Lurs Lemon from the penalty area, forcing a bit of different energy into the defenders of St. Chuck's.
Well, here we go. Connor out. And also Lurs Lemon out on a 4-point pass. Connor with 5.
Yeah, the jammers now trading score. Dill, Lurs Lemon.
And both these jammers back in the pack. With 4 and 4 on that last pass. That brings us to 91-63, 9 minutes and change left in the first half. We got a timeout being called, it looks like, by Brandywine.
Yeah, that was a slightly chaotic and hard-fought race of points in that jam as the two teams trading blows. On the penalty board, Zombie F-Bomb is St. Chuck's, currently sitting on 5 penalties. For the belligerents, Rapid Arrhythmia sitting on 4, and no one else in any serious sort of trouble, Dill.
We're seeing some serious jammer points by Connor with 33 jammer points so far. Jedi Nightingale, 25. Psycho Kitty Freakout with 33. And on the belligerent side, Lurs Lemon has 35. So we're seeing where the score difference is on St. Chuck's with 63-95, with Lurs Lemon having the major points for Brandywine.
That's right, Dill. Skinny Guinea putting up 12 points of her own across 9 jams, but that is mostly as the recipient of a star pass.
All right, and here we go, lining up on the Skate Girl start line, Raggedy Aneurysm and Jedi Nightingale. Jedi Nightingale and Raggedy Aneurysm with a little bit of a tumble right there before we get this thing started.
Jedi Nightingale getting fully recycled, and Raggedy Aneurysm has lead.
Jedi Nightingale still having a little bit of trouble getting out of that pack as Brandywine has set up a serious defense. That's allowing Raggedy Aneurysm the time to get around and get on the inside. Come out untouched, 5 points for Brandywine. Meanwhile, Jedi Nightingale has finally broke through the pack.
That doubles Raggedy Aneurysm's point totals. And a nice skip there, put up four more.
Yeah, just in time. She skipped through, put up four more, but still held St. Chuck's to zero.
Raggedy Aneurysm, when used as a relief jammer, she is often able to get that lead jammer status, but rarely has the opportunity to put points on the board. And she was able to pick up nine in that particular jam.
Well, here we go. Fast Girls start line, Slam Shine Alley for the Belligerents, and Psycho Kitty Freak Out for St. Chuck's. Both jammers trying to jockey to find a place, and Psycho Kitty Freak Out finds it first. She is out lead jammer right now for St. Chuck's. Hot on her tail, Slam Shine Alley, not wanting to let it go, forcing a call off. Psycho Kitty Freak Out. Didn't get 3 points. 3 points right there and shutting out Brandywine.
So St. Chuck's has been acting well in protecting this lead, although Brandywine slowly creeping up on them. 7.5 minutes remaining in the first period of play. St. Chuck's 98, Brandywine 72.
Looks like a team timeout will be called.
This one by St. Chuck's. We'd like to thank one of our local friends, Next Level Skate Shop. Thank you, Next Level.
Thanks. So right now we're sitting 98 to 72, 7 minutes and 22 seconds on the official clock. We have a team timeout right now by St. Chuck's. Some strong jammers in this contest right now. As we talked about earlier, not a whole lot of penalty issues. Zombie F-Bomb creeping up there with five for St. Chuck's. We're almost into this, done with the first half of this bout.
We are in the final day of this Division II playoffs in Cleveland, Ohio, but there is more Division II action to come. Do not forget, August 28th to 30th, next weekend, you can join us here on WFTDA.TV in Detroit, Michigan, for even more of this great roller derby action.
All right, for St. Chuck's, you're going to see Sugar Shock on the line with Buenos Dias from Brandywine.
Buenos Dias putting up 7 points thus far across six jams. Not as effective as she has been previously in the tournament. Maybe she can turn that around in this jam.
Well, she's definitely giving a good try of it right now as Terra Eyes was giving her some terrorizing moments as she finally breaks out of that pack as the lead jammer, Buenos Dias, around the pack quick and fast, wanting to close that gap. And she dives in almost unseen, but again, Terrorize waiting for her at the front of that pack. Had to let her go, suffered the penalty, out of play blocking, sends her to the penalty box, and that's still leaving Buenos Dias on that run that she is on right now. As she is quick out of the pack again, no resistance, with another 5 points for Brandywine. Brandywine wanting to set the tone right here as we're creeping towards the halftime. Into the pack she goes one more time. It's hard not to talk about it as she has broke free again.
Star pass for St. Chuck's. However, Buenos Dias holds the whip hand. She is able to call off the jam and does so. But what was I saying about her not putting up her previous numbers? She certainly made a dent in it there.
You can't really call that an announcer's curse. You can call it an announcer's gift. Let's coin that phrase so it'll be more positive. Announcer's gift, Slim. Thanks.
You are very welcome.
Thanks, Slim. Well, here we are on the line. That brought us to 98 to 87. As the clock continues, Lurs Lemon returning for the Belligerents and Jedi Nightingale for St. Chuck's. And just as I say that, Jedi Nightingale out of that pack as your lead jammer. Meanwhile, Lurz Lemon getting out of that pack on one knee, back up fast and quick. And hey, Jedi Nightingale, no big deal, just gets through the pack fast with four easy points.
Yeah, the four in the door from Jedi Nightingale. I'd say a conservative but very effective play. St. Chuck's is still maintaining the lead. They're at 102, Brandywine at 87. We got 5 minutes left in the first half and a whole other half to go.
Right, two rematches today, this Sunday. Exciting time in WFTDA history. And Raggedy Aneurysm for the Belligerents off the line with Psycho Kitty Freakout. Raggedy Aneurysm pushing into the center of that melee just outside of turn two.
No lead jammer yet declared.
Not quite yet. Oh, knocked to the outside thanks to number nine, Skinny Guinea.
Star pass to Skinny Guinea. Skinny Guinea seemingly everywhere at once as she was able to throw that devastating hit and then cruise back to the rear of the pack in order to receive the star.
Wow, she was doing all the jobs on the track right then. Blocker, jammer, all at once.
Rydell Skates.com, handcrafting quality roller skates for 70 years. Rydell Skates.
Slam Shine Alley for Brandywine. And Connor returning for St. Chuck's on the fast girl start line. And it looks like we have almost a full complement as St. Chuck's has one of their blockers into the penalty box. And Slam Shine Alley taking full advantage of that little bit of weakness as the lead jammer right now, Brandywine controlling the jam. Meanwhile, Connor is still trying to make her way through that pack just outside of turn two. As they move around, Slam Shine Alley making quick work of it. Five more points, again closing the gap. Back and forth we go with this score. As Slam Shine Alley once again deep into that pack, skirting on the outside. Notice that the player that knocked her out was down, so good eyes on her. Five more points for Brandywine.
Now within 5 points of evening up with St. Chuck's. Slam Shine Alley, a transfer from Philly, and I bet the folks in Brandywine very happy she came to town. Star pass for St. Chuck's. Tara Eyes, the new jammer for the skaters in black.
Well, we've seen this before, and Brandywine, of course, sees that happening, calls off the jam immediately, and guess what, Slim? Once again, we're sitting at a tie bout, 102 to 102, 2 minutes. This is some kind of palindrome.
Well, I do believe you're right. This palindrome break is brought to you by Radar. Gate man sees name, garage man sees name tag.
There's nothing we like better as announcers when things line up and there's a bunch of twos and ones and who knows what.
And so, we have pushed the reset button. Now it evens. Jedi Nightingale and Buenos Dias.
Right you are. Jedi Nightingale and Buenos Dias fighting the battle in the pack. Right now we're seeing Buenos Dias stuck in the back of that pack. Jedi Nightingale recycled to the back by the pivot.
Brandywine penalty, number 121. Crash Banshee will go to the DerbySupply.net penalty box.
And that pivot would have been Skinny Guinea, again, doing all the jobs. But here we go right now. That's going to let Buenos Dias out of the pack as the lead jammer. And Jedi Nightingale with a leisurely skate out of the pack right now.
Whiplash, the pivot for St. Chuck's, now going to the penalty box, and the jam called to a close.
And Buenos Dias called off that jam with, right now we're sitting at 102 to 105. Brandywine barely above in this contest. Two ties we had already.
But that is a change in the lead, Dill.
Lead change. All right, Lurz Lemon returning to the line for Brandywine.
She faces Connor. Connor knocked to her knees right at the Fast Girl start line.
Well, Lurs Lemon uses that as a distraction, or it was just a natural distraction, as she is out as the lead jammer back in the pack already, but not distracted anymore. Oh, right there, we're going to have a back block called on Lurs Lemon. That's going to send her to the DerbySupply.net penalty box.
Now, Dill Hero, I don't know if Connor is going to be in any shape to take advantage of this power jam, as she was leveled three or four times at the back of the pack by the Brandywine defenders.
Now, we've seen these two teams extremely physical before, and we're starting to see that right now. She does quick work of it, 5 points, but she's not as speedy as once before, maybe getting her wind back in her, but she did get 5 points right there for St. Chuck's. Connor still at it.
Connor with great footwork and even greater ability to shake off some of the pounding she took.
That's true. Right now we're seeing a three-and-a-half wall, if you will, that was stopping her, recycling Connor to the back right now, taking her all the way back. And Lurs Lemon has been released and scoring another 5 points for Brandywine.
Period time has expired. We will run the jam to its natural conclusion.
Right, and here we go. Lurs Lemon on a tear. Another 5 points for Brandywine, using the penalty box, I guess, as a little bit of a rest. She came out at 100%, fast and quick.
And just as we said, it's Lurs Lemon returning to the DerbySupply.net penalty box with a high block.
It looked like Whiplash might have been involved in that and sent her out. So here we go, another power jam. Connor still alone. Once again alone as the jammer. She's still working her magic in that pack. Teammates given a little bit of an opening for her. She dives in, and here we are in halftime. 2 points for St. Chuck's and five more for Brandywine.
And what a contrast we saw in that jam, Dill Hero. Lurs Lemon with the virtuosity in her ability to skate, but on the other end, a very different kind of talent from Connor, in that she was completely tenacious despite the fact that a lot of hits were being thrown her way as she negotiated her way through that pack.
Oh yeah, that tenacious is an understatement. After three devastating knockdowns, she got back up a little bit slow off the start, but still able to score points and bring it back and get it out from under her.
Whoo,
everybody breathe.
5 points apart, Brandywine 117, St. Chuck's 112. We are in halftime.
Yep, we'll bring it right back to you. We'll look at some stats and come back with some great information. And we'll see you in just a little bit, WFTDA.tv.
Welcome back, everyone, to the 2015 International WFTDA Division II Playoffs in Cleveland, Ohio. My name is Lightning Slim. I'm joined by my good friend, Dill Hero.
Hey, we were just talking about this matchup that we're seeing, the rematchup from Friday, how it's panning out today versus Friday. Now, last Friday at halftime, these two teams, St. Chuck's had 86 points and Brandywine had 11. Right now, there's not that much of a gap, but Brandywine is still slightly in the lead at the half. Will it be a tale to tell? We don't know. As right now, St. Chuck's is 112 and Brandywine's 117. How's the stats looking there, Slim?
Well, in terms of penalties, Whiplash on the St. Chuck's side sitting on 5. So is Zombie F-Bomb. Maybe a bit more of a story on the belligerent side. Lurs Lemon, who has been doing so much scoring for them and gaining lead jammer, is sitting on 4 penalties at the half, a bit dangerous for them. Rapid Arrhythmia also sitting at 4, and Skinny Guinea, their valuable hitter and pivot, sitting on 4 penalties.
Right, and we're getting ready to get back into this game. What happened, though, in that halftime when St. Chuck's was down just by a little bit, they ended up coming out of that contest as the winner. So Brandywine's looking for a little bit of redemption here today.
That is what is so exciting about a rematch, Dill Hero, is that one of two things is going to happen. A team is going to establish dominance, or someone is going to get revenge.
Right.
And those are both exciting things.
Yeah, actually. And then we can talk about what changed. I mean, these are still a few players difference, the same two teams playing in the same weekend. I mean, not a lot of differences. I think we're seeing a lot less penalties in this matchup as we did on Friday.
And we're not just about at evens on the scoreboard. St. Chuck's currently sitting on 27 penalties. Brandywine has 30. Not much difference there. Brandywine 12 leads and St. Chuck's with 11. So they have been neck and neck throughout the contest, although there was a bit of give and take and some swings. But now we sit Brandywine 117, St. Chuck's 112, and 30 minutes to go.
30 minutes of exciting gameplay. We've had two ties in the first half. I mean, this is just going crazy right here. Right now we're seeing on the fast girls start line lining up Jedi Nightingale for St. Chuck's. And from what I'm seeing, looking on from the DerbySupply.net penalty box, Lurs Lemon.
So a brief power start here for St. Chuck's. Jedi Nightingale, who's put up massive numbers for St. Chuck's thus far in this tournament. She's sitting on 29 points across 9 jams.
Well, here we go. The whistle has blown. Jedi Nightingale quick out of that pack in turn one. She is the lead jammer. No resistance holding her back as she gets through the pack, setting a stage for the second half of this bout. 112 to 117, but that's not going to stand for long as she is already deep into the defense of Brandywine. Meanwhile, Lurs Lemon making her way off of the penalty box and making her way through that pack on her initial pass.
Effective defense from Brandywine as Jedi Nightingale is on a scoring pass, but they are holding her at the front.
Yep, Jedi Nightingale taking a 2 second, if not even shorter, to look around and keep her eye on the prize and calling off the jam right at the last moment. 5 more points for St. Chuck's.
So Jedi Nightingale was contained. She was not able to get out of the pack and come around for another pass, but in her defense, she had already gained all 5 points.
And look at this. Third tie score in a row or during this bout. This is the third tie we've been in.
We're all tied up, folks.
All tied up. And they've got her all tied up right there in the jammer line. Buenos Dias represent from Brandywine and Psycho Kitty Freakout for St. Chuck's. Buenos Dias making her way through the front of that pack as the lead jammer. Brandywine now in control. So Buenos Dias is coming back into the pack quick and fast as it stands still in turn three.
Big Red making a somewhat lackadaisical roll over to the DerbySupply.net penalty box. She's sitting there now.
And Buenos Dias, with a little bit of confusion, thought she was called out from the whistle. Not called back. Called back into play immediately as soon as she gets in play. Calls off that jam. Very smart move by her. 3 more points for Brandywine.
And Brandywine able to break open that tie and reestablish their lead now, sitting at 121 to St. Chuck's 117. Just under 28 minutes remaining.
All right, Lurs Lemon returning to the line for Brandywine.
What do you folks out there think is going to happen? You can get a hold of us on Twitter using the hashtag TalkToWFTDA. That's Talk numeral 2 WFTDA.
And Sugar Shock out of that pack fast and quick for St. Chuck. She is the lead jammer. Meanwhile, Lurs Lemon with a hang up right in turn one. Oh, skirting in the outside. And I don't mean skating. She was sideways skipping.
And I think that's the first time another jammer has taken lead away from Lurs Lemon in this contest.
Wow. Well, Lurs Lemon not wanting to take it easy as she was knocked, recycled to the back and now caught up in this St. Chuck's defense. Both jammers respectively caught up in the defense 2-wall right now, holding Sugar Shock as Sugar Shock is just pushing very slowly to get these blockers outside of the engagement zone. They had to let her go. 5 points right there for St. Chuck's. And we had another lead change, 122 to 121. As it stands, the jam still continues.
Out-of-play penalties mounting here for St. Chuck's as they hold up Lurs Lemon as long as they possibly can.
Well, there we go. It's going to three-wall was going to shut that down as this jam comes to an end. Another 3 points for St. Chuck's. Wow.
Whiplash of St. Chuck's has received 6 penalties in the danger zone.
Jedi Nightingale returning to the Fast Girls start line.
I'd like to thank Adam Skates at adamskates.com. Adam Skates, train hard, play smart, skate Adam.
Raggedy aneurysm for Brandywine, and the whistle has blown, believe it or not, even though they're standing still. Somebody's going to break this pack free. Who will it be? The pack is in fast motion right now as we see Raggedy Aneurysm working her way to the front. A little bit of a spin. These two jammers are out at the exact same time, but Raggedy Aneurysm takes the lead jammer, and they were matching each other, decides to call it off. That was a crazy jam.
Jedi Nightingale, maybe she wasn't standing still, Dale. Maybe she was concentrating so she could use the Force.
Well, that would explain why all of a sudden everything exploded and there were two jammers on the run. So right now, Slamshine Alley for Brandywine and Psycho Kitty Freakout for St. Chuck's. 125 to 121 in favor of St. Chuck's.
25 minutes to go.
Wow, the excitement continues. Psycho Kitty freak out almost out of the pack. Meanwhile, a track cut. Oh, a track cut and a back block, respectively. Back block on Slamshine Alley, track cut on Psycho Kitty freak out. Both jammers go to the penalty box, touch it for 2 seconds, and they're back in play. Let's just pretend it never happened as they are back on the track. Still counts as the penalty on the score, though. But they are back in play.
And both of them inside the pack getting some physical attention from the defenders.
Physical attention indeed.
Psycho Kitty Freakout knocked down a couple of times. Rapid Arrhythmia getting into it with her.
Wow, Psycho Kitty Freakout still struggling with this defense right here. You're talking about Rapid Arrhythmia. Last line. Oh, a nice hit by Rapid Arrhythmia.
It's a duo formed by Rapid Arrhythmia and Not Naughty. A duo act knocking around Psycho Kitty Freakout, although finally she's able to stretch them out and escape. Star pass for Brandywine. Slamshine Alley has handed off the star to Not Naughty.
Yeah, couldn't get through the pack. Not Naughty now taking on the jammer responsibilities for Brandywine. Psycho Kitty freak out with 4 points. It was quite an event for her to get through the pack that first time, and now she's back in play.
Not Naughty now in a scoring position. She is out with four.
Out with 4 points, Not Naughty. Looked like she was taking almost a defensive position just before she turned around and took off. Out of that pack, that'll end this jam. What a crazy jam. 129 to 125.
Now, Not Naughty did something that Skinny Guinea did earlier in the first half, in that she was up at the front of the pack throwing some crazy, crushing hits and then cruised to the back of the pack and received the star like it was nothing. And
both of them
did it in the same manner. And I'm wondering if that's an intentional set play that Brandywine has set up. If so, it's a fascinating one.
Yeah, it's something I haven't seen. I've seen it twice here right now. Just taking it easy to go get that star and then busting out of there. Obviously, it paid off this last one when they have 4 points. Right now, Buenos Dias for Brandywine and Connor for St. Chuck's. Buenos Dias up to the front right now. Three wall trying to shut her down. Buenos Dias not having much luck getting through, breaking it apart on her own, but quickly absorbed by a number 22. And that's going to give Connor that opportunity to get out of that pack and call off the jam.
Lurse Lemon now taking to the Fast Girl start line. Was Lemon a little penalty heavy in the first half, although she did receive 4 penalties, but also racked up 47 points across 9 jams thus far.
Yeah, that's something she's going to, I'm sure they're watching out for. She's one of their main scorers for Brandywine.
Only Buenos Dias comes close with 29.
Well, Jedi Nightingale out of the pack as the lead jammer for St. Chuck's. Wow, quite a spin move right there by Lurs Lemon as she readjusts her elbow pad and gets out of that pack quick and fast, but not in time. Jedi Nightingale calling it off.
4 points there for Jedi Nightingale.
137 to 125, 20 minutes left in this rematch bout. The second of two.
Let us take a moment to say thank you to Jackson. Jackson Skate, for the love of it, Jackson Skates.
And on the fast girls start line, Raggedy Aneurysm for Brandywine and Sugar Shock for St. Chuck's. Wow, Sugar Shock immediately pushing up the middle. Her team surrounded her and gave her just this opening that she could easily take out of one, and she is now the lead jammer.
Sugar Shock a little quiet in the first half, but maybe at halftime opening up a can of Popeye spinach, as she's been quite effective.
Yeah, there it is, the secret, the Popeye spinach. Raggedy Aneurysm coming around the pack right there, squeezing out 0 points and 2 points on for St. Chuck's, 139 to 125.
If you missed out on any of the exclusive 2014 playoff and championship merchandise last year, you can complete your collection at the WFTDA online store, which is found, perhaps not surprisingly, at wftda.com/store.
Slamshine Alley on the line right now for Brandywine and Psycho Kitty Freakout returning to the line for St. Chuck's. The action is underway. We're going to see Slamshine Alley recycled to the back right now, and that gives an opportunity to Psycho Kitty Freakout to get out of that pack as your lead jammer for St. Chuck's. Slamshine Alley still in the pack right now as we're seeing Psycho Kitty Freakout.
Star pass for Brandywine, not naughty as she did before, receiving the star in a scoring position right away.
Well, that was almost tricky. Let's see, 3 points right there for St. Chuck's, and one, it did work out for them, one for Brandywine. That star pass effective for 1 point, 142 to 126. They'll take every point they can get in about this close.
Well, gaining 1 point for themselves and also shutting down the other jammer as they force the call off.
That's
so
true.
quite effective.
All right, right now, Buenos Dias joining us on the line for a Brandywine and Jedi Nightingale for St. Chuck's. Jedi Nightingale trying to take that outside and staying stuck in the back. Meanwhile, Buenos Dias trying to force her way through as they are. I can't even describe what's happening here with the two wall, squeezing her, had to let her go. There was a lot going on, and now she is the lead jammer.
Buenos Dias lead for Brandywine. There's a three wall in front of her.
Well, she tried to take that center of the three wall, knocked out the pinion, as it were, and weakened the three wall, and that paid off. 5 points right there for Brandywine.
Good physical play from Buenos Dias to physically challenge that link and that three wall ahead of her and just barge her way through.
Yep.
She even pulled a penalty on the opposite side while doing so.
Yeah, she definitely did. What quite a move, and it's paid off once again. Now she's through easily with 5 points, and then she's on her pass. One contender to deal with, another 5 points. So that's 15 points right there just after she knocked that three wall out.
Buenos Dias with lots of room inside and a spin at the end.
Wow, Buenos Dias taking us a lead change right here for Brandywine in the lead right now with St. Chuck's 143, Brandywine 145.
That was a 19-point jam for Buenos Dias, bringing her up to 48 points across 10 jams in the match.
Wow, well, here it is, 143 to 145, another exciting game here on Sunday. All right, off the line right now, Lurs Lemon once again, and Connor. Lurs Lemon out of the pack immediately. She is the lead jammer right now, Brandywine with the 2-point lead. Lurs Lemon controlling the jam. Meanwhile, we're seeing Connor stuck in the front of the pack just inside of turn two. Wow, look at that. Lurz Lemon getting through the pack as if the path was made for 5 points for a Brandywine. Brandywine on a tear these past two jams.
Connor struck down there.
Well, this is a testament to Brandywine's defense holding Connor back to the back of the pack. Meanwhile, here we go. Another 5 points for Brandywine. Lurz Lemon quick out of that pack. Oh, making, a dive over number 417, Shakilia.
Lurz Lemon with another great spin maneuver there. She's known for doing those.
Well, that spin maneuver is allowing her to get out of these situations, except this time when she's being called out for a back block.
That will be penalty number 5 for Lurz Lemon. And once again, the difference in the style of skating between her and Connor, who has been simply quietly and steadily racking up points for St. Chuck's.
Well, one person of defense representing Brandywine right now on that track. It's a 3-1, and they're being sent out to the penalty box. Brandywine's returning from the penalty box. That'll open up a slot for her. A lot of Brandywine penalties during this last jam, and that's allowing St. Chuck's to close the gap as we're at 158-160. It's going on right now.
If Connor makes it out of the pack, she would have been able to equal the Brandywine score, but Lurz Lemon was also able to negotiate the pack one more time. Where does that leave us on the scoreboard, Dill?
Oh, my gosh. We have an official review going on right now. But right now, St. Chuck's is 163 and Brandywine is 164. We have a one-point bout. We've seen three ties so far, back and forth just by a few points, not even any runaway during this bout, this exciting rematch. Both these teams, you know, St. Chuck's is wanting to hold on to the fact that they beat Brandywine before, but Brandywine's wanting to show him, no way, we're going to take this thing back. Right now, they're just doing it by 1 point.
14 minutes, 30 seconds remaining. Whiplash of St. Chuck's has already committed the seventh deadly sin. She's been removed from gameplay. Big Red of St. Chuck's sitting on 5 penalties. Zombie F-Bomb also sitting on 5. Trouble on the Belligerent side also. Rapid Arrhythmia on 6 and Skinny Guinea on 6. Both of them have been working very hard in the pack for Brandywine.
Right, both these teams working hard and, you know, obviously suffering the penalties. I'm wondering if that spin move we were talking about earlier from Lurz Lemon is somehow indicative of getting more penalties as she spins through the pack as opposed to, you know, making a decisive hit. Maybe it's a little looser.
Lurz Lemon is also a jumper, and we've seen her.
All right, so we're going to find out what that official review is all about. We'll give you the information as soon as we have it. Double H is checking on the situation right now. Again, a barn burner. We've used that term very frequently this Sunday.
I think we have some clarification on that call from Double H.
So St. Chuck's is actually questioning whether or not that forearm penalty occurred against Whiplash that would foul her out of the game. So they are taking a think session and trying to remember whether or not that was an accurately assessed forearm.
Wow, a very important official review right now as the decision on this will decide whether she gets to stay in this bout.
Yeah, that would make a very significant change to the bench of St. Chuck's to have her back.
So, hey, don't forget, you can talk to us at Talk, the number 2, WFTDA on Twitter. Yesterday, we had some international tweets going on from Australia, Ireland, England. Hello, world and universe. Anybody off the planet that wants to tweet at us, that'd be great, too. And we could talk about all this stuff.
And since the matter at hand concerns penalties, I would like to draw your attention to DerbySupply.net, sponsor of our penalty box. For all your derby needs, DerbySupply.net, just hit it.
Put the forearm pried out and put the opposing skater out of bounds, thus the call will stand.
Well, there it is. We just found out the call will stand. Whiplash is out of this bout right now.
Yeah, head referee 2D Tin Whistle meticulously describing how the forearm in question put the opposing skater out of bounds. So that one stays in.
Yeah. Well, St. Chuck's is going to, we'll see how they adapt to that situation right now. Again, 163 to 164, such a close bout. 14 minutes and 30 seconds on the official clock. It is starting to happen. Another exciting game on Sunday. I've said it time and time again. Right now we're looking at Raggedy Aneurysm on the line and Psycho Kitty Freak Out. Raggedy Aneurysm out of the pack first, and she is the lead jammer.
Psycho Kitty Freakout has also escaped the pack, but Raggedy Aneurysm moving at speed.
Wow, Raggedy Aneurysm with quite a pileup, making a way for herself as she gets through there, calls it off immediately with 4 points for Brandywine.
Raggedy Aneurysm charged into that pack, knocking over a St. Chuck's defender, and I think Raggedy Aneurysm herself expected the whistle to blow and perhaps receive a back-blocking penalty, but the referees did not see that from their perspective, so she is able to put up those 4 points.
Yeah, if she expected it, she must have just got lucky and hit right inside the engagement zone. Well, here we go. Slam Shine Alley for the belligerents, and Jedi Nightingale returning to force some points up as she becomes the lead jammer and now is engaging Slam Shine Alley. Jedi Nightingale using her lead jam to just hold on for a minute and engage Jedi Nightingale. Calls off the jam immediately and then no points.
And since that jam was so short, Jedi Nightingale being reset on the Fast Girl start line to face Buenos Diaz.
And we have a 2-on-2 pack for each team right now. Very thin out there right now, giving the jammers plenty of room to do what they need to do. Jedi Nightingale and Buenos Diaz. Jedi Nightingale
puts the shoulder into the pivot of Brandywine to make her own space. Jedi Nightingale is lead.
Wow, we are seeing a lot of jammer, their own defense as they are working, making their own holes very physically, not just looking for an opening, but making an opening. Jedi Nightingale diving in on her knees. It's gonna, she saw the forearm block right there from, a lot of whistles blowing right now. Forearm block right there for Velociraptor, sending her to the penalty box. Looks like 4 points for St. Chuck's. 167 to 172. Brandywine right now holding the lead.
Current high scorer, Lurs Lemon of the belligerents, 66 points across 11 jams. Connor of St. Chuck's on 63 points. And nearest to them for the belligerents, Buenos Diaz with 52.
And Lurs Lemon so far able to hold down the penalties, and she's still just at 5. Lurs Lemon using a huge jump on the inside line, and she is now the lead jammer. Brandywine controlling the jam. Oh, we're going to see a track cut right there for Jedi Nightingale. Jedi Nightingale not looking too happy about that and actually hesitating. Oh, being called back in. Jedi Nightingale was called back in. It was a strange situation. 5 points on the line right there for Lurs Lemon. They called her out for a track cut, but then called her right back in.
And Jedi Nightingale, yeah, with a shake of the head because she knows that that cost her some seconds as she was called back on again. And
yeah, that I mean, that 5 points, at least it might have cost her some points. We don't know, but 5 points for Brandywine.
Brandywine 182, St. Chuck's 167, just under 11 minutes remaining in the contest.
Well, Raggedy Aneurysm for the belligerents and Sugar Shock for St. Chuck's. Sugar Shock is pushing her way through. Oh, look at that right now. Raggedy Aneurysm called out for, it looks like, a forearm block. Yeah, forearm block to the penalty box, and that's going to leave Sugar Shock all alone. That's the jammer anyway. There's plenty of pack out there right now as we're seeing 4-on-4.
Terra Eyes trying to make some room there for Sugar Shock. Tornado blocking there from St. Chuck's, trying to make some room for the Jammer, but then they take the back and stretch things out.
Skinny Guinea with the direct contact there and helping that three wall hold Sugar Shock as best as possible. Sugar Shock now picking it off to a two wall. They had to let her go, and there she goes with five more points for St. Chuck's.
Decker Hader taking the out of play penalty as the last point on that bridge.
Raggedy Aneurysm rejoining the fun and action on the track right now. Sugar Shock again with a three wall. Will she be as effective as she was just a second ago at picking it apart? Slow moving right here outside of turn four. Meanwhile, all the action, Raggedy Aneurysm dodging and weaving, trying to find it, making her own little opening right there as she gets through on her initial pass.
Sugar Shock decides to call it off. She's had enough of the buffeting she was receiving inside the pack. She does pick up an additional 4 points for St. Chuck's.
We're at a timeout official. Brandywine's calling a timeout right now.
Yeah, they're using their official review official for the review. Period.
Official review, we're sitting at 176 to 82, 9 minutes and change left in this bout. Will it be St. Chuck's or Brandywine? St. Chuck's, remember, on Friday won that matchup, and right here we are, St. Chuck's a little behind Brandywine.
We'd like to thank our friends at Bont. Visit them at bont.com, where you will see FXX wheels, hottest wheels on the market, Quadstar certified cutting edge technology from Bont.
Well, we'll get some clarification on that official review from just a little bit later as they are coming to conclusion they're talking about. I believe it had something to do with the back block. I'm not 100%, but we will definitely get clarification from our producer, Double H, when that comes in.
All right, it does look as though Brandywine is asking for a back block call on the opposing jammer in the previous jam. I believe that was number 18, Sugar Shock, if I'm not mistaken.
Yes, Sugar Shock, jammer in the previous jam. Always risky on an official review to ask the officials to cast their minds back to previous events.
Well, if this does stand, Sugar Shock, that would be her first penalty of this bout.
Yeah, Sugar Shock with 23 points across six jams, very effective in that position and skating very cleanly.
Well, as the discussion goes on, we've talked about this 100 times, 176 to 182, such a close bout, tying back and forth, playing going on right now. The second of two historical rematches in WFTDA tournament history. These teams lined up, but now they're in a higher seed, so no matter what happens, they're going to come out a little bit higher in this contest than where they came in.
Take that screen grab, folks. There is the penalty board. We'd like to take the opportunity to thank some of our friends like 5-on-5 Magazine. Thank you, 5-on-5, and one of our local friends here, Derby City Skates. Thank you, Derby City Skates.
And this official review continues. Raggedy Aneurysm last season, scoring 591 points during her last season, and Buenos Dias, 496 points. Huge scores, and then Skinny Guinea with 486 during their last season coming into this matchup. That's a pretty...
Especially for Skinny Guinea, huge numbers for someone who's being used as a pivot.
Yeah, like a secret weapon almost, a somewhat secret weapon. We saw some star passes going on.
Skinny Guinea and also Not Naughty were gave that same maneuver in which they threw a hit, took the star, and moved forward.
Yeah, I have to think you're right about that. Earlier we were talking about how this must be a play that they kind of worked on. We've seen the same exact play a few times, and if so, like you said earlier, that's pretty amazing.
Well, they took a bite, and they got PB and J.
the PB and the J.
Penalty totals, St. Chuck's at 40, Brandywine at 49. Not too far apart, considering that Brandywine is on the upper end of the scoreboard right now.
Yeah, the higher the score, a little bit higher in penalties.
Maybe they took a couple of the worth of kind.
There was initiation to the back that did gain 1 point. That point will be removed, and the Black Jammer, St. Chuck's number 1A, will begin a penalty in the box.
Sugar Shock. Sugar Shock of St. Chuck's. So they will deduct 1 point from St. Chuck's total, and Sugar Shock, we're going to have to take a seat. And a power start now for Buenos Dias.
Right, that's her first time in the DerbySupply.net penalty box. She's not probably not used to those accommodations.
And well, that was some vision from the bench of Brandywine to call that official review and ask for something so specific.
Well, and it obviously worked out right now in a couple ways. Buenos Dias, the only jammer on the line right now for Brandywine, gives them the power start, and it puts her in the penalty box. It's working out for him right now as she is the lead jammer. Right now, Buenos Dias controlling the jam. The pack is waiting for her not so patiently just outside of turn two as she dives right in to the offense. That is St. Chuck's last line of defense right there. Looked like Big Red had to let her go.
Sugar Shock has returned from the DerbySupply.net penalty box.
Well, here we go. Sugar Shock back in play. Buenos Dias trying to work her magic again and still in control of this jam. We're seeing Sugar Shock still having to make an initial pass. Buenos Dias getting through that pack with four more points for Brandywine.
Currently 191 to 175.
Wow, no resistance at all. An easy pass for her. Five more points for Buenos Dias. Talk about taking advantage of your official review. That set the tone for this jam. And Buenos Dias once again coming through. Four more points, calling off the jam. Wow, what an effective official review that was to set the tone for this jam. That sets Brandywine at 200. St. Chuck's still sitting at 175. 7 minutes and change left in this bout.
18-point jam for Buenos Dias. Wow. And you're right, Dill Hero. That official review once won, setting St. Chuck's back on their heels a bit, and that allowed Brandywine to start putting some of those systems they've been experimenting with in this tournament into place. They're going to try to start running their program.
Well, run their program they did, and right now we're looking at Slam Shine Alley and Jedi Nightingale. Jedi Nightingale trying to take the outside path, and she... No pass, no foul. She will not be eligible for lead jammer.
And Tara Eyes blocking for St. Chuck's raises her fist in victory as she has drawn a penalty on Slam Shine Alley.
She thought she had it. Cutting the track is going to send her to the DerbySupply.net penalty box, and that leaves Jedi Nightingale all alone. And that's exactly what St. Chuck's was wanting, to have a jam that they can do with what they will. And she's trying to do with what they will right now as she finally breaks out of that three wall. Five more points for St. Chuck's. Now we're at a 20-point game. 6 minutes, 19 seconds left on the clock.
This is nail-biting stuff, Dill Hero. Jedi Nightingale knocked down in the center of the pack. A low-blocking penalty will result.
Yeah, Jedi Nightingale with a crazy hit from number 121, Crash Banchikoot.
She will be joined by number 789. Decker Hader, and also Skinny Guinea. No room at the end for Skinny Guinea. She's going to have to rejoin the pack and serve her penalty at a later time.
Wow, Brandywine filling up that penalty box right now, just waiting for Jedi Nightingale to come through and take advantage of that two-woman block that we're seeing, a blocking machine that we're seeing. It didn't make quick work of it, and there she, tried a giant apex jump, almost a whole track jump. It didn't work out. She landed on the inside, so she crawls back to the back of that pack.
Jeddah Nightingale already had 5 points on the previous pass and decided to go for a higher risk maneuver. Almost puts herself into orbit. Didn't quite work, although she recovered long enough to put up 4 more points. What were we saying, Delhero, that Brandywine was going to start working their system?
Working their system. And what happened is St. Chuck started working a system of their own. It was all about that recovery. If she would have not gotten up so quickly, Jeddah Nightingale, and got those points on the board, we wouldn't be sitting at a 10-point bout right now. 194. 11-point as the score changes. 194 to 205. Brandywine still in control. And off the line, Raggedy Aneurysm and Psycho Kitty Freakout. Psycho Kitty Freakout fast in that pack and quick on the outside. She is now your lead jammer. St. Chuck's not wanting to take that official review setup they had 2 jams ago. Psycho Kitty Freakout in the back of the pack already as she is trying to fight her way through just on the inside of turn three. Calls off the jam. Did she get some points? Yes, she did. 3 points. Keeping Brandywine at zero. Slim, we are working our way towards the tie mark. Can we see 4 ties in this game? 4 minutes and change left on the official clock.
That was such an effective use of Psycho Kitty Freakout. We had not seen her in several jams, and so the choice by St. Chuck's coach to put her in with fresh legs was just the thing the situation required.
Fresh legs. Right now, Jeddah Nightingale back in the pack, and Lurs Lemon. Lurs Lemon, again, we talked about her penalties. They're still sitting at 5. She's been playing it safe this second half, and she is your lead jammer right now. Lurs Lemon from Brandywine controlling the jam. Jeddah Nightingale fast on her heels. Lurs Lemon jumps in, grabbing 2 points, keeping St. Chuck's at 0. Now we're at a 10-point deficit, 197-207. Brandywine still in control.
Hoo-wee. We'd like to thank the Atom family of products, Bionic, Pilot, Vertigo, a winning combination from Atom.
Slamshine Alley back out on the fast girl start line, joined by Connor from St. Chuck's. The whistle has blown. The jammers are getting in their respective positions, but what we just see, Slamshine Alley pushes to the front in turn one, and she is now your lead jammer. Slamshine Alley quickly joining the pack just as it gets outside of turn one. No movement hardly on the pack, even though it seems like they're going fast, but she makes quick work of that with 5 points for Brandywine. And here we go, Connor on her initial pass, breaking out. Well, this pack is spread out, like it's 3-on-3 right now. Or 2-on-3, actually, with St. Chuck strong, and she calls off the jam. Wow.
A quick update here. Skinny Guinea, number 9 for Brandywine, has received her 7th penalty and has left the bout due to accumulation of penalties, as has Big Red of St. Chuck's.
Wow, two main blockers in their lineup are gone now. 197 to 215, 1 minute and 49 seconds left on the official clock as we're seeing Buenos Dias and Jeddah Nightingale battling it out. Jeddah Nightingale with a big hit coming out of the pack. The ref has to check it out. There's so much going on. But, yes, she is the lead jammer. Meanwhile, a forearm block is going to send Buenos Dias to the DerbySupply.net penalty box, and that's going to leave Jeddah Nightingale all alone. Can she bring up this deficit? 197 to 215 as it stands, and she is in her scoring position.
Jeddah Nightingale, burst of speed, comes out with 5 on that, although a penalty to her teammate here, number 831 of St. Chuck's, Joni Ramon.
Joni Ramon playing roller derby for a long, long time. She started out on arch rival, and she's been in this game for a while.
A bit of a sweep attempted there. Didn't quite work as Jeddah Nightingale gets stuck into a front wall. Buenos Dias tried to return from the penalty box and was bidden to head straight back, so a double penalty. More time for Jeddah Nightingale. The score is so close, just about 30 seconds remaining in official time.
Well, there she goes. She gets in and calls it off with 5 more points for St. Chuck's. That double penalty would be like the olden times where we have a full minute in the box for their jammer. And St. Chuck's taking advantage of it. 211 to 215.
Well, even in the short penalty era, absolutely disastrous, Dill.
Right.
211 St. Chuck's, Brandywine, 215, 4 points apart. St. Chuck's taking a timeout.
16 seconds on this clock. 4 points.
I think my heart took a timeout sometime during that previous jam.
We talk about wanting to be able to take announcer timeouts. Sometimes when we're having a heart attack up here, we might need it, but we're not going to get it. Now we're seeing some chants going on right now. St. Chuck's call to arms from their fans and their team. And Bueno's.
So we've had a couple of foul outs. Whiplash leaving for St. Chuck's. Big Red also exiting. Skinny Guinea leaving on the Brandywine side. Skinny Guinea fouling out in last night's contest also. That could be costly for Brandywine. They depend on her, well, as the full PBJ, as we were saying earlier.
Well, here we go. Timeout right now from St. Chuck's. Now, remember, St. Chuck's won this bout on Friday. 206 to 196 was the final score of the St. Chuck's versus Brandywine on Friday. So right now, St. Chuck's is down by 4 points. Again, these two teams are going to leave in a higher seed. St. Chuck's seed 7, Brandywine seed 10, and they are battling for the 5th and 6th position right now. So no matter what happens in this bout, they're going to leave a higher seed than they were.
Yeah, both of these teams should feel good about their progress at this tournament. They've bettered their position. I'm sure they both want this pretty badly right now, though, Dill.
Yeah, and they should definitely feel good about this bout that they're playing. I mean, this is a tight bout. As you can see and hear at home, this is 211 to 215, 16 seconds on the official clock. Right now, Buenos Dias and Jedi Knight. Buenos Dias sitting in the penalty box. Jedi Knight, the only jammer on the track. Full complement of blockers for both teams. Quite a pileup just outside of turn one as they are battling right now. Jedi Nightingale gets out of that pack as the lead jammer. Official time has come to an end, and we are going by the jammer clock right now. 1 minute and 38 seconds by the jammer clock. Jedi Nightingale in a scoring position and lead jammer a dangerous position. 211 to 215 as she has dived into 5 points. 5 points up in the air.
Will five do it?
Five will just do it. She called off the jam, knew that by 1 point, didn't want to take any chances, but Buenos Dias was out of that penalty box at the last second.
An incredibly nervy maneuver by Jedi Nightingale as she swiveled around. I'm not sure if she even saw the referee's hand in the air indicating she'd scored all five, but she called it off.
Yeah, she knew that if we had Buenos Dias back in play, it was going to be a much harder battle. I feel like she gambled and won. It could have been anybody. He's still holding up the five as they're out there discussing the final thing. It's such a close.
So, Dill, let's talk about how we got to this situation. Buenos Dias, having received a penalty in the previous jam, got another one on top of that as she had an illegal procedure for entering in front of the play. And that's what got her second penalty of the previous jam, got the power start for Jedi Nightingale, and if this score stands, paved the way to another victory for St. Chuck's.
Paved a very tiny, tiny path for another victory for St. Chuck's. Brandywine, no matter how this folds out or comes out of this, has to be proud of their performance this weekend, as well as St. Chuck's. Once again, this is determining 5th and 6th place of this Division II tournament, the 2015 International WFTDA Division II, right here in Cleveland, Ohio. Burning River Roller Derby putting on this great event for us. WFTDA.tv, live and in person.
We are in an official review situation with a 1 point victory. Everybody wanting to cross the I's, dot the T's.
Upon review, all blockers on the track were passed. Points will stand.
Wow, that was a scary moment
wow.
for each team. It could have gone either way. We would have had a tie game or, you know, it could have been anything. Who knows? But the official review, you heard it right there.
Another final jam victory for St. Chuck's. The official name of the team is the Pack in Black. They may want to change it to Heartbreakers when they face Brandywine.
Still some conversation going on. This is such a crazy game. We had a lot of penalties there at the end. People fouling out. Double foul at the end. St. Chuck's is now cheering right now. It seems, yes, the referees have blown the final whistle and are coming through. It says final on our board. That was scary to announce as the final score. 215 Brandywine, 216 St. Chuck's. Slim, the celebration is happening right now on the floor.
Dill Hero, they call it Division II, but right now it is first in our hearts for action. You couldn't ask for a closer finish than that, and what a wonderful back-and-forth bout between St. Chuck's and Brandywine. Brandywine trying to put together these strategies, dipping their toe in the D1 level strategy and putting together set plays, but St. Chuck's playing the spoiler, always managing to bring a bit of chaos onto the track and work it to their advantage.
Right, and then a little bit of a gamble at the end. I mean, there was maybe it could have been not five, but she took a chance, called off the jam, had her eye on the jammer, and here we sit. 216, 215, final score. Brandywine, 215, St. Chuck's, the winner of this. St. Chuck's now coming out of this contest as seed five, and Brandywine coming out as seed six. Well, that'll bring us to our conclusion. Slim, it has been a great pleasure to call with you again on another great bout this Sunday. Thanks to Double H for producing us and running around and getting the information for us. I'm Dill Hero, and this is Lightning Slim, and we'll see you on WFTDA.TV.